Now we'll move on to the first issue, where I'll tell you about the importance of pre-cleaning. Let's start with where the name Machine Day comes from. According to the 7 steps of implementing autonomous maintenance, the first step is a general cleanup. The name Machine Day was adopted to emphasize the importance of this event. It is no more than a celebration of the machine, where everyone takes the time to get it as close to perfect as possible. The whole concept of general cleaning is not just about making the machine shine. It's mainly about identifying the so-called anomalies during the cleaning process. For example, problems on the machine that could develop into a major breakdown in the future that would limit the machine's availability. Cleaning is a general term. Now I'm going to try to give you a point-by-point overview of the purposes of cleaning. During cleaning, the work group, because you need to know that it is not only the operator who cleans, but we will talk about that later in the lesson. When cleaning the equipment, the deepest corners of the machine, the cleaning participants pay attention to the conditions of the components and parts they are dealing with. That is, in addition to cleaning, paying attention to the conditions of the machine. The next thing is to identify and visualize those irregularities that they notice while cleaning the machine. All of this is done in order to prepare a list of malfunctions to be removed by the maintenance department. I think that you and I are not very fond of cleaning, so it is not at all about cleaning. That is why an important element of cleaning is to identify the places where the contamination occurs. We are all talking here about contamination resulting from poor machine conditions, for example, leaks, as well as process contamination. With a list of such spots, we'll be able to remove the technical ones, and in the case of the process ones, reduce them by, for example, using additional guards. The next goal is to identify hard-to-reach areas and basic lubrication of machine components that require it. So we use the cleaning time for these activities as well. Hard-to-reach areas are, firstly, those areas of the machine that are difficult to clean, and secondly, those areas where it is difficult to read basic machine parameters, such as pressure, fluid levels, for example. Machine Day is the day that starts the preparation of the machine for the operator's prevention. So if we already see here that the indicator, for example, pressure gauge, is set in such a way that the operator will have to stop the machine to read the value, then this point should be recorded in order to set up the instrument in the future so that the operator can perform the inspection as efficiently as possible. Moving on, the next objective is a simple selection, which you already know well if you have watched the 5S method course on our platform. If not, then I will also recommend this topic as a basic tool to use before implementing TPM. Using a machine stop, we remove all unnecessary items, tools, fixtures, etc. Finally, the issue of getting to know the machine. I told you earlier that Machine Day is preparation for machine maintenance. On the one hand, the machine has to be put in the best possible condition, and on the other hand, it is time for the first training on how the machine is built and how it works. The training is usually the responsibility of the maintenance staff, who also take part in the cleaning. Let us now pause for a moment at the point concerning the anomalies mentioned. You need to remember what is the difference between a failure and an anomaly. If you look at the iceberg shown on the slide, at the top part of it is its failures, the shutdowns that we all see. We see them primarily in the performance results of the machine. These are the stoppages that cause performance degradation. We are able to tell that a failure has occurred. In contrast, what is below the surface of the water under normal conditions is invisible to us. These are the anomalies. Situations that we are able to notice if we carefully look at the machine, bend down, look behind the covers. Of course, time should be allocated for such activities. Machine Day is an introduction, then the necessary cleaning activities should become a habit and part of the cleaning instructions within the 5S system. The material on TPM rounds, this is another lesson in this course, discusses case studies that show how negative and costly the consequences are for a company when we just pretend to have 5S and it is limited to just a general cleanup of the workstation. I encourage you to explore this lesson as well. I will list the major problems that result from inadequate cleaning. Quality defects. Machine malfunctions cause the appearance of defects. These are often situations where the product loses its properties. Dimensions and keeping the process within tolerant limits requires constant control and interference of the machine adjustments from the operator. In the case of quality errors, the employee is often blamed, but it is not the employee who is to blame. The problem lies in bringing the machine to a normal state of work, and then this will translate into repeatability of the process. Speed losses are called microstops, which are brief machine stops for the purpose of adjusting or slowing down the machine, usually resulting from machine malfunctions. In this situation, we do not run the machine at the full speed cycle assumed by the technologist, but slow down due to fear of damage, deterioration of the machine, a consequence of not reacting sooner. The further away from the removal of the anomaly, the more likely it is that the machine will come to a stop. Deterioration of the machine obviously leads to greater wear and tear on the components and therefore to higher repair costs. The final piece of this puzzle may already be the damage to the machine itself, which, as I mentioned earlier, involves limitations as well as health and safety hazards for the worker himself. These situations usually occur because there is no time for a clean and no time for service. Remember that sooner or later, this approach will result in increased costs for the organization. So far, I've told you about goals related to the state of the machine itself. There are also goals that are generally related to raising the awareness and qualifications of the employees themselves. Employees acquiring knowledge during pre-cleaning become more responsible for their machine. They start to care about it more. Cleaning isn't just about maintaining technical condition, it's also about safe working conditions. The leaks that I mentioned earlier are elements that threaten daily operations. Employees will begin to see the value from reporting anomalies. They will see that reporting and removing anomalies improves their working conditions. If we don't see problems, if we don't show them, we can't act. If we don't act, we don't improve as an organization. If we don't improve, our competitors can overtake us. This is how this point can be briefly summarized. Problems are opportunities, and cleaning reveals problems. The next three points relate to improving skills in the operation itself, as well as identifying problems and their sources. During cleaning, employees often have their first contact with the inside of a machine. This is an opportunity to get to know the machine from a different perspective. To summarize the first part of our lesson, the main task of general cleaning is to remove any machine malfunctions and stop the machine degradation process.